Okay, so after getting a stable DSTV signal, you need to connect your cables to the spiral decoder. Okay, so you have to connect your coax cable from your satellite dish at the unique cable port. Okay. Okay, so if you are to connect it to AV port of any flat screen television or an old TV set, you need to use this cable. You set it here. Yellow for yellow. Yellow is the video, so yellow for yellow, and then white for white. Red for red. And if you are to use an HDMI for your flat screen television, with the HDMI you get quality pictures as compared to the AV cable. So if you are using a flat screen television, you need to use an HDMI cable. Okay, so we connect it over here, and then you connect your adapter to power your decoder. Okay. Okay, so whenever you power your DSTV decoder, this is what will appear on it. The language page, which is the first page that will appear. So you select your language. If you are good with Portuguese, no problem. So we move on with English. Press OK on your remote. Okay, so the second page is the satellite page. And with the satellite, if you are living in these listed countries over here, Botswana, Malawi, Mozambique, Namibia, South Africa, Swaziland, Zambia and Zimbabwe, you need to select this satellite, IS20, and then you move ahead with the same step that we'll be using. But if you are not living in these listed countries, if you cannot find your country name in this list, you need to change the satellite name to E36B. That's for the rest of Africa. So if you are living in Kenya, Nigeria, Ghana and other African countries, you need to select E36B and then move on. So you come here, the next page, move down to manual setup. Okay. So with the LMB type, any Express decoder, you need to choose Unicable TM/SAT-CR, because you cannot install any universal LMB with Express decoder. So you need to select this LMB type, Unicable LMB. Okay. So you don't have to change it. And the user band frequencies have to be default. Have to leave it as it is. You don't need to change anything over here. So you come down to scan option, and on the right side of the page, the status, signal status will fill up. If you reach here and your signal status are not filled up, meaning you are not having enough signal, or you can check your coax cable, maybe you have not fixed it well. So you come here and then you put it on scan, you press OK to scan. Okay. Okay, so after scanning your DSTV decoder, you need to upgrade before you can activate. If you skip the upgrading process, it will not activate. You cannot activate it. So after scanning any new DSTV decoder, a pop-up message will appear here suggesting for an upgrade. So you don't have to skip. You have to press OK on upgrade now to upgrade your decoder. So you don't have to off your decoder when the decoder is upgraded. And after upgrading, DSTV request for your IUC number and the serial number of your decoder for them to complete the activation. Okay, so you will find this IUC number at the back of any DSTV decoder. They used to place some stickers either on top or at the back of it. Okay, so you submit these figures to them and then they will ask for your location and your mobile number to complete the activation. And whenever you are calling them, make sure that you have enough airtime. It's not free calling DStv office for the activation. So to get your contact number, you pick up your remote, you go to DStv menu, and then you look for help. Okay, help. Come to contact us over here, and you will find every details about DStv. So you come here, call centers, and then you have South African number. Every country can have your own number over there. Okay, so you have Angola, Botswana. So you can find your country number over there. Okay. So if you are new here, you do want to subscribe and then hit the bell icon. Alright. Bless up.